Today we are going to study about transportation in plants. We have already learned about transportation in human being. Today our main focus is regarding the transportation in plants. Before doing this topic, you must know what is transportation in plants. Transportation means process of transport of substances from one part of the plant body to other. For a small distances, that is between adjacent cell, it can be done by the process of diffusion. Diffusion means transfer of material from higher concentration to lower concentration. For a greater distance, transportation cannot be achieved by diffusion process, that can be achieved by conducting pathways known as xylem and phloem tissue. Now students, you must know the pathway for transportation. There are two main pathways for transportation in plant. You know that plant body is not very much complex as that of human body. That is why two materials are to be transported in plant body. One is water and mineral from soil to the leaves, and second one, food made from the leaves to other part of the plant body. So dear children, the transportation of water and mineral from root to leaf can be achieved by first conducting pathway, that is known as xylem, and transportation of food by another conducting pathway, that is known as phloem. The transportation of food means the soluble product of photosynthesis, that is glucose made from the leaves to other part of the plant body, can be done through pathway phloem tissue. Simply saying, we can conclude that there are two conducting pathway for transportation in plant. One is xylem and second one is phloem. Now you can see this diagram. Diagrammatically it is represented over here. You can see arrows. Soil is the richest source of water. Then roots are taking water from the soil and transported towards the upper direction, that is towards the leaf. Water and mineral. Mineral is dissolved with water. With water, minerals are also taken by the roots by the process of osmosis. Osmosis means transfer of liquid material, that is water, from higher concentration to lower concentration, and it is transported towards the leaves. You know that for photosynthesis, one of the main inorganic substances required is water. When water reaches the leaf, carbon dioxide also reaches the leaf, then by the process of photosynthesis, glucose, that is a soluble product of photosynthesis made by the leaf, and it is transported to different part of the plant body with the help of phloem tissue. The diagrammatically shown the transportation of water and mineral from root to the leaves and food from leaves to other part of the plant body. Now you can see this, how water and mineral is transported. Little detailed way we are going to study now. Root take water and mineral by the process of osmosis. Then it is transported to the leaves, because leaves are preparing food for the plant. It is transported to the leaves with the help of xylem tissue. Xylem tissue consists of two non-living group of tissues, tracheids and vessels. These tracheids and vessels are present in root, stem and leaf. That means xylem tissues are present in root, stem and leaves. Tracheids and vessels in the xylem tissue connect to form the conducting pathway for water and mineral. And through this conducting pathway, water and mineral are taken towards the leaf. There are two main factors responsible for this transportation of water and mineral. The main factors are, first factor is transpiration pull and second factor is osmotic pressure. You know, dear children, through the leaf, loss of water take place in the form of water vapor through the lower surface of the leaf, that is through stomata. Due to the loss of water from the leaves are having a low pressure area for water molecule. Due to that, water molecule is sucked towards the leaf. That process is known as transpiration pull. Similarly, osmotic pressure. Osmotic pressure means transfer of water from root to leaves through selectively permeable membrane. That is transfer of water from higher concentration to lower concentration. Then question may come like this: what are the processes or what are the factors responsible for transportation of water and mineral? First one, transpiration pool, and second one is osmotic pressure. Now you can see diagrammatically transpiration in plants. You can see students, leaves are having stomata. Through stomata, water in the form of water vapor escape out. That process is known as transpiration. Due to transpiration, leaves are maintaining a low pressure area. Due to that, by sucking action, water is taken towards the leaf. Now, second process, that is translocation. Translocation is the process of transport of food, that is glucose, from leaf to other part of the plant body through phloem tissue. Phloem consists of two types of living cells, sieve tubes and companion cell. These sieve tubes and companion cell connect to form the conducting pathway for food material. The conduction of soluble product of photosynthesis, that is food, can be done by diffusion process and energy stored in ATP. Diffusion is the process in which material or substances are transported from higher concentration to lower concentration. That is, from leaf, food is made. It is a high concentration area. From the leaves, food is transported to other part of the plant body. This process can be speed up by the energy stored in ATP. Now, you can differentiate between xylem and phloem. Xylem is the conducting tissue for transportation of water and mineral from root to leaves. But phloem, it is a conducting tissue for transportation of food from leaf to other part of the plant. Xylem consists of tracheids and vessels, but phloem consists of sieve tubes and companion cell. Xylem allows the passage of water and mineral only in one direction, that is in upward direction. But the transport of the food is in both direction, food in both direction, that is upward and downward direction. This is about transportation in plants, dear children. Now I am going to wind up my video and I will come with another video very soon. Thank you, students.